Hey there, if you're new to DaVinci Resolve, don't have the Resolve Editor's keyboard or the Speed Editor and want to learn some keyboard shortcuts, then this video is for you. The first thing you should know is if you're coming over from another editing platform, is that you can actually remap your keyboard commands in Resolve to whatever you are used to using. You can do this simply by clicking here in the menu bar, then selecting keyboard customization, clicking the drop-down menu here and selecting from your preferred alternate NLE keyboard layout. In here, you can also customize a stack of keyboard commands. It really just is up to you. I use the default layout in Resolve because it keeps things simple and aligns with the manual in case I need to look something up. Okay, so one of my favorite easy to remember key commands is the command or control plus and minus keys. This will zoom in and out of the timeline wherever the playhead is. As you do this, you will see a visual representation of how zoomed in you are on the timeline here. But if you want to snap zoom in and out, you can use the Shift Z command. Shift Z will zoom in and out between however tight your setting is here and fitting the entire edit into the viewer. This command is really helpful in big edits where you just want to jump around and into the timeline quickly. Once in the area where you'd like to start adjusting edits, you can use the up and down arrow keys to quickly skip forward or backwards between edit points. For more precise frame by frame control, you can use the left and right arrow keys to move the playhead with audio through a clip to find a desired edit point. When you are this zoomed in or focusing on frame by frame editing, the full stop and comma keys also come in handy for precise clip movements, as these keys will slip footage either up or down the timeline, frame by frame, but unlike the arrow keys, will not give you any audio feedback. Next, like most modern NLEs, we can use the J, K, and L keys to play in reverse, stop, or play forwards in the timeline. Multiple clicks of the J and L keys will activate fast forward and reverse playback. If you want to jump quickly to the start of the edit, you can use the home key and the end key will jump you to the end of the timeline. Next, we have the Alt Y key command. This command will select everything forward of the playhead and when combined with the Shift Z command will speed up your workflow immensely. So we can use the Shift Z to zoom into the timeline, then Command B to activate the cut tool to cut a clip where we wish to make an edit. After making the edit with the blade tool, we can use the A key to deactivate it, then the Alt Y to select everything forward of the playhead, then Shift Z to jump out to the full timeline viewer to make sure everything we wanted is highlighted in red, because you have to be careful with this key command as it can also collect stuff you don't want to move. So I would advise, if you're in a complex edit like this one, check all the active tracks before you move any media, and that nothing is selected that shouldn't be. If something is selected that shouldn't be, control or command clicking those clips with your mouse will deselect them. Now we can simply move the selected footage with the mouse to where we want it, or slip all the selected media with the comma and dot keys. Once moved, if you would like to check your edit in full screen mode, hit the P key and this will expand your viewer in and out of full screen. Then you can use either your spacebar to play the timeline in real time, the J, K, and L keys to change the playback direction and speed, the up and down arrow keys to quickly jump between cuts. I think you get where I'm going here. Now to exit the full screen viewer, you can either hit the escape key or the P key again. Now, depending on whether you're using a full size or a mini keyboard, that will determine if the next key command is relevant, but it's worth learning anyway. In Resolve, there is a difference when using this delete key and this delete key. On some keyboards, one of these may be labeled as a backspace key and the other as a delete key. But in general, this one is usually the backspace and this one is usually delete. And there is an important difference between the two in Resolve and the way they behave can trip up newbies. What you need to know is both keys will delete a clip from your timeline, but when you use the backspace key to delete a clip, it will leave a gap in the timeline. opposed to the delete key, which will perform a ripple delete that removes the undesired media and closes the gaps on the timeline. That means when you use the ripple delete key, everything forwards of the deletion point will slide back down the timeline and can affect other unintended clips on the timeline. If you're a new user that's sticking to the basics, keep an eye out for any other changes that may happen when you use the ripple delete key. Just keep an eye on the tracks above and below where you're committing to the ripple delete. Another handy keyboard shortcut is to know how to activate or deactivate in and out points on the timeline when focusing in on a certain sequence in your edit. I would like to make some adjustments in this section here, so I'm going to use the I key to add an in point here. As you can see, there is now a gray bar running across the top of my timeline. Now I'm going to go to the end of the section I wish to make changes in and hit the O key. I have now selected a range of the timeline that I would like to edit within. Again, I can use any of the previously mentioned keyboard combinations to go full screen, control playback, or even make an edit. But if I play the edit timeline, you'll see that the playhead range isn't limited to the selection that I've made. So to just play the selected portion, we are going to click Command or Control forward slash, and this will activate the loop playback mode. As you can see, this allows me to focus in on this part of the edit and make the changes I need. Then I can repeat the command forward slash to disable loop playback, then go to the Deliver tab and use these same markers that we set up before to just render out this selected portion of the timeline for editorial or client approval. After the render is complete, I can use the Option or Alt X command to remove the in and out timeline markers. Now it's important to remove these markers as they can cause copy and paste issues, which I have explained in a video up here, and I highly recommend you watch it. Okay, here's the obvious ones: cut, copy, paste, and undo. These are fairly standard across all computer systems and most software. Command Z, X, C, and V, I'm sure you know them all. But what you probably didn't know is that Resolve can also just copy attributes from one clip to another. This works by selecting the clip that you want the attributes to be copied from and pressing Control or Command C. Then all you need to do is select the clips where you want the attributes to be copied and press Alt V. As you can see, this command opens a context window where you can then select all the attributes that you would like copied. And this can be anything from zooms, props, or even effects. It's a great way to save time, especially if you're doing stuff for social media that requires lots of snappy edits, resizes, effects, and such. Look, any keyboard edit that saves you time and gets you closer to finishing a project faster is a winner in my book. Which leads me to my two favorite shortcuts: Control S for save and Control Q for quit.
Swipe up, tag your friends, like and subscribe, comment below. If I make this follow, don't let this flop, wait till the